What is ambience? There are a number of definitions for ambience or ambiance. One that works fairly universally is the character and atmosphere of a place. If we put that into audio terms, we can think of ambience as the character of the space in which we're hearing a sound. So we often think of adding a room ambience effect to a track, for example, or maybe putting a microphone up in a room to capture the space's ambience. Many engineers and musicians think of ambience as a type of reverb, and in fact, the opposite is actually true. By the definition I just mentioned, any reverb is a type of ambience. But generally, we use ambience to refer to a very short reverb along the lines of what you might hear in a small room. An ambience effect of this type will typically contain mostly early reflections. In a real room, early reflections are sound that comes off a source, hits a wall or other surface, and reflects back to your ears. The small amount of time required for the reflection to travel, and the relative density or amount of reflections, as well as the tone of the reflections, which are affected by the room's surfaces, create the character of the ambience. Ambience effects typically don't include a long reverb tail like you'd hear in a large hall or a big space. Rather, the overall decay time is very short, half a second or so or less. And in many cases, ambience is felt more than it's really heard. It's the sort of thing that you miss when it's removed, but it doesn't jump out when it's there. It provides air around the dry sound and helps our ears to place a sound within a space. Now, ambience is used to make a sound seem more natural in a mix, as if it's in a room, to make it richer, to add depth. It can also be used on a mix or a submix to bring tracks together, to sort of glue them together, and to help them coexist as if they're in a single environment. In some cases, we use a short delay to create ambience, but a reverb ambience will be less noticeable and more subtle. Let's listen to some quick examples. So here's a dry rimshot sound from a drum kit. So let me play our dry sound, and then I'll add a short room ambience to it. And now here's a little different type of ambience. Again, bypassed. And just for comparison, here's a third studio ambience from a different reverb plugin. If you want to learn more about audio concepts like this, visit the News and Research page at Sweetwater.com or check out the other videos in our Glossary Terms playlist.